Namaste, I'm Lakshmi Nair.
And I'm Naina Swarita Ars. We represent Underwriters Laboratories and work towards advancing UL's public safety mission in India.
Out of its 1.3 billion population, India is home to 548 million children, covering 29 states and 7 union territories. Every child is important for the family, society and the nation, and hence the safety and survival of every child is the responsibility of each one of us. India has seen nearly 500,000 child deaths in the last decade, and this is mainly due to their difficulty in risk perceptions, curiosity, impulsivity and risk-taking behavior. The economic impact of injuries in India is significant, though unmeasured. RTIs alone are estimated to cost 3% GDP every year, and the cumulative cost due to all injuries might be around 5% GDP. The impact is greater among children, as those who survive have to live for the rest of their life with minimum or no participation in activities of life. We didn't find a single source that has collated this data, and hence together with National Institute of Mental Health and Neuroscience, NIMHANS, a national report titled Advancing Child Safety in India, Implementation is the Key, was released by us as a part of our ongoing work in the area of advancing public safety in India. Commonly, children spend majority of their time at home, on roads and vehicles, in schools or educational institutions, in recreational areas and others. In all these places, children come in contact with a variety of products that can lead to injuries or unsafe environments that can enhance the occurrence of injuries. While it's important to make every product safe and less injurious, a larger environment where children spend time need to be made safer. Ultimately, an environment that is safe for a child is safe for everyone. The report also includes the insight from safety appraisals conducted across 131 schools in Bengaluru and Kolar districts. These schools were assessed and scored on physical infrastructure, road and fire safety and first aid facilities. The research team developed a digital safety appraisal tool based on various existing national level guidelines and attempted to quantify safety level percentage in every school. From the primary research, overall safety in schools were observed to be 50.8% of expected levels. While RTIs emerged as the leading cause of injury among children, what was equally alarming to note is that 90% of the schools did not even maintain any injury-related health record.
This is a first-of-its-kind technical and advocacy document that provides information for stakeholders to plan appropriate safety interventions for children in India. The study revealed that while various policies and legislations like the National School Safety Guidelines, the National Disaster Management Authority's School Safety Policy Guidelines, the National Building Code, etc., are in place to promote safety and prevent injuries to children, there are several implementation challenges. The existing guidelines, legislations, and standards need to be strictly rolled out by strengthening mechanisms at the local level, including funding to specifically carry out certain recommendations. The report also emphasized the need to increase awareness about the safety standards in schools amongst the key stakeholders like the policymakers, law enforcement, governments, school management, and parents who play an active role in making India safer for our children. Injury prevention is a cross-cutting issue involving departments of home, transport, education, health, social justice, and youth empowerment, and is a shared responsibility of several ministries, agencies, and departments. There is a need for creating mechanisms and institutional approaches between the different ministries and departments to realize cost-effective outcomes and reduction in deaths and disabilities. Innovative, comprehensive, and acceptable strategies for enforcement and implementation of existing laws, policies, and programs is very much required. child safety and injury prevention needs a serious consideration from all policymakers and professionals, along with highest political support. Needless to say, children should not die or become disabled, nor seek care in healthcare institutions for conditions that are predictable and preventable. It is time to act.